I know black is beautiful. I went for it myself. Went home, painted my house black inside and out. And the first thing I lost was my bowling ball. Then I lost a wife and three kids.
Yes, Mr. White, who was your first choice as running mate?
Well, I tried to latch on to Nancy Wilson, but she outran me.
Mr. White?
Yes,
Mr.
Sir.
White, what do you think it'll be like being the first black vice president?
Well, I might not be black by the time I take office.
Well, how can that be?
Well, you know how a big, thick, juicy steak can cure a black eye?
Yeah.
I'm having a suit made of meat.
Mr. White, do you have a campaign slogan?
Yeah, in your heart you know he's white. And it's better to run with a black man than from one.
Mr. White, you said that a black vice president could improve our relations with unfriendly powers. Which ones?
The NAACP, CORE, and Nipsey Russell.
Mr. White, what is black power?
Prune juice.
Well, what is white power?
Milk of magnesia.
Mr. White, what's the biggest problem for you as a black man with the second spot on the ticket?
Trying to find a white man for the first spot on the ticket.
Mr. White, who first asked you to be the Democratic candidate?
The Republican Party in Cicero, Illinois.
Mr. White, if you're a Democrat, how come you don't have a donkey up there with you?
Because nobody likes a smart ass.
Mr. White, why do you have your campaign headquarters in a gambling casino?
Because if there's that many fools in there, some of them will vote for me.
Well, Mr. White, earlier in the evening, your staff was looking all over for you and couldn't find you. Where were you?
I was gambling. I was over to the whitejack table. And we gotta do something about these damn slot machines. Every time I pass one, the watermelons go, psst.